So hello everyone, I'm Huy and my partner is Minh Văn Nguyễn. So we will represent our research that dense resonance for endoscopic image classification. So firstly, we will talk about our problem, our project. So nowadays, so endoscopic images are used a lot in a lot of medical center. So there are lots of people go to the hospital and they have to take the endoscopy. And there are lots of images, endoscopic images that was produced by that process. And that is the reason why there are many doctors have to work a lot in order to analyze what is disease in these images. And they have to diagnose it every day. So that is the reason why we have to we have the idea to develop an AI application, actually an algorithm that in order to diagnose the disease in the endoscopic images. So this will help the doctor to accelerate the time to detect the disease and screening the disease. So let's talk about the Kavasi dataset. So Kavasi dataset is an open dataset that have 8 label with 8,000 images. With 8 labels are dilated polyps, dye resection machines, esophagistic, normal sacrum, normal pylorus, normal xyli polyps, and ulcerative colitis. So we will talk about the related work that we are used in our project. So firstly, we have to talk about the transfer learning. So everyone know that when we train a model from scratch, like we have to build an architecture and we have to build a feature engineering for the architecture. So this will get a lot of time. So now with the development of the neural network architecture, so there are lots of pre-trained model that was built before, like ResNet, DenseNet, Deception, or Inception. That is the reason why we use transfer learning. We have our data set, and then we can use the pre-trained CNN model to do our task. And yes, you can see that the accuracy when we use transfer learning is so high, and we get the competitive score of the model performance. And yes, the image nest is one of the important things to develop the pre-trained model that can help us to do this task. So next, we will talk about the ResNet. So the ResNet architecture is the architecture was proposed in the previous year. So in ResNet architecture, there is a special thing is the residual block. So the previous feature will be stored and it will be used for the later features in the later layers in the network. And so we can see in the on the right, this is the ResNet architecture. We will have a lot of residual block with a deeper, with more and more layers of CNN model. With residual block, we can reduce the vanishing gradient when we training model. Yeah. And DenseNet, with DenseNet, so in DenseNet, we will have a module to use in convolutional neural network that can connect all layer with matching feature map size. And to preserve the feed-forward nature, each layer obtain an additional input from all predicting layers and pass on its all feature maps to all the subsequent layers. And contrast with ResNet, we never combine feature throughout summation before they are passed into the layer. Instead, we combine feature by concatenating them. And you can see the DenseNet and symbol dense block and symbol dense net. So our proposed method that is then ResNet architecture that we use the ResNet backbone and DenseNet backbone, particularly ResNet 101 and DenseNet 121 with a convolutional 2D to with ad layers to predict the label of the endoscopic images in the Cavasia dataset. So with the input, so it will divide into ways that is ResNet and DenseNet. So with this architecture, so the feature will be extract 2 times by ResNet and DenseNet. Then we will calculate the sum of the values in the feature map of the output of the 2 backbones. And yeah, we will use this feature map to create the input for the global average pooling in order to classify the label of the our data sets. So this is our explanation in the ensemble feature. It's the technique that we use in our proposed method. So firstly, we can see that we have 8 × 8 and 2048 number of filters, and we will see the under. So we will have 8 × 8 × 1920 number of filters. So when we pass to the convolutional 2D with the number of filters of 1024, so we will have the same size of the tensor, and we will calculate the sum of 2 tensors to create the output for our classification process in the layers. And this is the output when we visualize this feature. So this is the output on ResNet 101, and this is the output on DenseNet 121. When we pass these two output in the convolutional 2D, so we can see the sum of the two output layers. So the output on our proposed architecture, this is the feature of our proposed dense ResNet. So we will see the feature are visualized more preferred than the old features on the previous backbone. So this is our setup for our environment. So we will do the experiment in the Cavasia dataset with 8,000 images, and we will test on the GPU NVIDIA Tesla P400. So we set the value in the first training is box size with 32 and with 10 epochs, and learning rate with 0.001. So the image size we set in the two train process is 256. And yeah, when we have the first training, we'll start to fine tuning the model in order to get the output of our process. So this is the loss and validation loss and validation accuracy in our training process. So we get the competitive score in the 2 process with more than 90%. So our evaluation on the Cavasia dataset, another test set that was created in the Cavasia dataset, which include 4,000 images in order to evaluate the model. So we get the accuracy is 63%, and with the high precision recall and F1 score. Yes, we also evaluate our result on confusion matrix. So we can see there are some misclasses on class 1 and class 5. Yes. So we have to improve it to get the better score. And our future work can be, we can try new backbone combination on our proposed network. So on our proposed architecture, we can try more some other backbone in order to get a better result, and we can improve the number of quality of the data to get the better result, or we can optimize the architecture to get the better evaluation, and we can cost the efficiency computing resource, and we can deploy it to cloud computing system in order to create a real product that help the doctor in the real life, or we can get this architecture to solve in the different tasks like CT scan or chest X-ray, for example. So this is the end of our presentation, and we have a implementation on our GitHub. You can use it. So thank you very much.